Hello everyone, welcome to Mathematics Solution Channel, and in this lecture we are going to solve another problem by using the Lagrange's mean value theorem. So the given problem is verify the Lagrange's mean value theorem for the function f of x is equal to sin x in the interval 0, pi. Now we want to verify the Lagrange's mean value theorem for this function sin theta or sin x. Now we know how to verify this. So first thing we want to verify, f of x is continuous. Now substitute 0, you will get sin 0, that will become 0, sin pi again that will become 0. Anyhow, we got the finite value. So f of x is continuous in the closed interval, that is 0, pi. And second condition, we want to find the derivative of that particular function. So given f of x is equal to sin x, then f dash of x will become cos x, right? And which belongs to the open interval of 0, pi, or we can say that f of x as a derivative of the open interval 0, pi. If these two conditions are satisfied, then we know then there exists at least one value c of x in the open interval 0, pi, or in general a, b, such that we know f dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. Now we know all the value, and before that we want to find what is f of b and f of a. So this is the a and this one is the b value. So f of 0 is equal to, substitute this, because this is the f of x, if you replace x as this endpoints like a and b or 0 and pi, you will get it. So f of 0 is equal to sin 0, which is equal to 0, and f of pi is equal to sin pi, which is also 0. Now we got all the values, substitute here. Now already we know f dash of c, correct? That is f dash of x is equal to cos x. We know f dash of c, if you just replace x as c, so you will get cos c is equal to f of z pi minus f of 0. So f of pi minus f of 0 divided by b minus a, that is pi minus c 0. Now cos c is equal to, the numerator is 0, so 0 by anything that will become 0. Now c is equal to cos inverse of 0, so we are getting cos 0 is pi by 2, so c is equal to pi by 2, which also belongs to 0, pi. Hence the Lagrange's mean value theorem is verified for the given function f of x is equal to sin x in the interval 0, pi. And this is the second problem which we are going to verify by using again the Lagrange's mean value theorem for the function f of x is equal to e power x in the given interval 0, 1. So already we have discussed many times, even though we have proved the Lagrange's mean value theorem. So using that conditions, we can verify the function by using the Lagrange's mean value theorem. The first thing we want to verify, whether it is continuous or not. Substitute 0, you will get finite. Similarly, if you substitute 1, again you will get finite. Anyhow, the given function, exponential function, is continuous only. So the first point, f of x is continuous in the closed interval 0, 1, or the given interval. And second thing, given that f of x is equal to e power x, now we want to find the derivative. So it is very simple, because f dash of x, the exponential term, will become e power x only. Therefore f of x is differentiable in the open interval of 0, 1, in the open interval of 0, 1. Now if these two conditions are satisfied, then there exists at least one value c of x in the open interval 0, 1, or the generally a, b, such that f dash of c is equal to right? F dash of c is equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. Now you know this is the a value and this is the b value. First we will find what is a f of 0 and f of 1. Then here f of 0 is equal to e power 0, that will give 1. Then f of 1 is equal to e power 1, that will give 1. Okay, or you can write e value as a 2.7, right? Now substitute this value in this equation. Let us take number 1. Then e power c is equal to f of b minus f of a, that is f of 1 minus f of 0 divided by 1 minus 0. So already we know this is e minus 1 divided by 0. Now e power c is equal to e minus 1. Now we want to find only the c value. For that I'm going to take log on both sides, and before that I know the e value, that is 2.7 minus 1, you will get 1.7, that is e power c. I want to find only c value, and I need to verify that it is lies between the open interval of 0, 1. Now take log on both sides, so you will get c is equal to log of 1.7, and moreover this is base e. Now this value is, if you verify in the calculator, you can check it, that is c is equal to 0.531. so obviously this is also lies between open interval of 0, 1. Therefore that particular value, that c, right, which lies between the open interval of 0, 1, that c value is 0.531. So that's it. This function we have verified by using the Lagrange's mean value theorem. Thanks for watching.